guys, and welcome back. In the coming weeks, I'll be looking at a multitude of subjects and material. To get started, I'm looking at the basics of a DIY project. By showing everyone where to start and what you'll need, I feel it will give any aspiring crafter the means to try and learn and grow by actually tackling all those projects they always wished they could do. This will be the first of my series of Back to Basics. Today I will start with something very basic, but a lot of people take it for granted. Your work area and the importance of the layout. The first thing is to look for a suitable size work area. Make sure it is a comfortable location where you can work on any project for a long period of time, taking into consideration that any project may take more than one day to complete. By having an extra square piece of board to work on, you make it much easier to move your project around and also to work on different angles. I have found that this has saved my project on numerous occasions and also helped me when the project gets too big and cumbersome. These clear plastic bags was a wonderful find at my local grocery store. You will find them in the same aisle as the normal black bags. I usually only cut off the sealed end of the bag and voila, a nice piece of flat, clear plastic. The plastic has multiple uses, this being one of the most important functions that I have found. I always start out by covering my work area. This has saved my table and my project on multiple occasions. It has served me well by actually starting my project with the board a bit back from the edge. It is in a comfortable reach position but still leaves enough space in front of it for me to be able to use all my tools and extra boards that I might need to continue with my projects. Overhead lighting and a desk lamp is very important for any craft area. Shadows can play tricks on the eyes, and to make mistakes in such a dark area is very easy. It also helps a lot if you are prone to headaches or fatigue. Find a basic layout that works for you. It is not necessary to spend a lot of money on fancy containers. In my case, I have used some old glass bottles to organize all my items in a manner that I feel will work for me. The way you lay out your table is very important. Things will never look this clean once you have started a project, but getting used to a layout from the beginning helps you work without interruption. You are able to see if anything is missing, and it alleviates the frustration of remembering what you have to work with. If I had to make a list of the top 10 items that I will start any project with, it would be my old plastic cutting board. As you can see from this picture, this one has been used numerous times for numerous projects, but I have found that it is one of the most versatile items on this list. These plastic boards always have a very rough surface, and this makes it very difficult to clean. I have found by using 4 layers of cling film, it alleviates the effort of cleaning the board every time and also helps make it nice smooth surface when it comes to doing your clay work. Having one of these craft boards is a very handy item to have. You will need it especially when you start doing your raw cutting of materials for your projects. This board will never stay in a pristine condition, and having cut lines on it means that you've actually used it and used it very well. For projects where I need a bigger clay rollout surface, I also tend to cover my board with 4 layers of cling film. This picture is to show how important the layout and work area is. In this shot, I was actually moved to a smaller space on my table because my table was being used for a gaming area. The project became cumbersome and I actually did not work on it again for the rest of the week. So get comfortable and make space for yourself. Next time we'll be looking at the basic material that you need to start a project and where to find them. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel. You will get updates for all the new videos I'll be loading in the coming weeks. If any questions, suggestions, please feel free to leave them in the comment section. Till next time, crafters.